his UG in the year 2002. He was awarded the late Yadavji Trukamji Acharya Award for authorship of the book Padartha Vijnanam Evam Ayurveda Itihasa by Khadiwale Pratisthan, Pune in the year 2016. He has also published various books and research papers in Ayurveda. He was a vice principal of Ashtanga Ayurveda College, Pune. Currently, he is working at the Ashtanga Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya. With utmost gratitude, I would like to invite Dr. Manoj Chaudhary, sir, to speak on this session. Sir, please.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Am I audible properly?
Yes, sir. We are audible.
Yeah. Thank you very much. First of all, I would like to thank the organizing team at the 4th Global Ayurveda Festival, that is a virtual international conference and expo. So I will share my views on behalf of Ayurveda Teachers Association, which is national association and stakeholder of Ayurveda Academia. So let me allow. So I'm representing here as a team member of Ayurveda Teachers Association. So friends, in 2030, One Nation, One Health System is proposed by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, and that policy by 2030 will be adopted. So it has already been envisioned in the National Health Policy and the National Education Policy brought in by Modi government in 2017 and 2020 respectively. Now, I would like to put forth some new ideas regarding this. Okay, so let me share slide one by one. So which would integrate this policy is to integrate modern and traditional systems of medicine like allopathy, Ayurveda, and homeopathy in medical practice, education, and research. Now see, this background or backdrop we have to understand. There is a need to integrate the different forms of the treatment, and the government is trying to shift the focus away from the pathy part of the medicine, which means that it should not matter if it is allopathy, homeopathy, or Ayurveda, as long as the person benefits from the treatment. It is for the benefit of the patient in all means. See, if a patient comes to a hospital, they can be given allopathic treatment if their condition is serious, but they can also be given Ayurvedic or homeopathic treatment in the same hospital if their condition cannot be managed with those. Now for this, a committee headed by Dr. Paul Sir, which is a member of health of Niti Aayog, has been formed, and everybody knows about that, the framework for the integrative health system in order to achieve inclusive, affordable, evidence-based, person-centric healthcare. Okay, so this committee is also developing a roadmap for disease prevention and health promotion on national programs. The NHP also recognizes the need of the integrated courses of Indian system of medicine, modern science, and Ayurgenomics, a combination of Ayurveda with the study of all the genes of an organism called genomics. It is also about getting Ayu system to contribute to meeting the national health goals and objectives through integrative practices. Now the policy, One Nation, One Health System, is expected to be rolled out by 2030. For that, the four working groups are formed: education, research, clinical practice, and public health and administration. And these groups are supposed to, you know, study how the other countries, such as USA, China, European nations, they are translated integrative medicine into their own system, health system. Also, these groups will study the India's own experience and integration of Ayush and modern medicine, and also the legal aspects in the implementation of integrative medicine. Now, moving ahead, this is the backdrop. So India must present Ayurveda in the next decade. Many years, this debate or the discussions are going on, and some organizations, even though health ministry, especially Ayush ministry, is starting taking positive footsteps for it. So India is a civilizational state and not a nation state. In this context, the contribution of Ayurveda to its civilizational legacy cannot be understood and undetermined. So in the 21st century, the time is ripe for India to concentrate and take major steps to posit Ayurveda as a health science and knowledge system, not just for herself, but for the world. So several states in the India are also emerging as Ayurveda hotspots. Just now, respectable dignitaries have talked about the Kerala state, Himachal Pradesh. There are a large number of professionals from various fields in the US are visiting, which is also enabling the state's local tourism substantively. But what is the future of Ayurveda in, say, the next decade? Where would policymakers, especially I am representing teachers or academia, the leaders, practitioners, doctors, therapists. So for 2030, we should be ready, and the robust thinking process should go on. And this is a very nice effort made by GF 2021. So the present scenario is the Central Council of Indian Medicine, which is India's principal regulatory body for Ayurveda education, recently released a notification. Dr. Agarwal has talked about it, that the 58 types of surgeries are allowed for Ayurveda postgraduates. The move has created a stir in the community of allopathy doctors, many of whom have asked if CCIM's notifications was really necessary, and they are opposing continuously. Also, the Indian Society of Dental Surgeons, they are also requesting for the integrated modern medicine and dental curricula. Now, Ayurveda practitioner is being allowed to perform modern surgeries, which must ask if Ayurveda college are well equipped to teach students these procedures. So generally speaking, in India, private medical colleges don't train students as well as state-funded institutions also. This is the fact. And there are more chances of improvement of such institutions. And they are trying to do, but they have to accelerate their efforts more and more. Most UG and PG Ayurveda colleges are privately owned. The National Education Policy 2020, the National Health Policy 2017, the National Medical Commission Act 2019, the National Commission for Indian System of Medicine Act 2020, and the National Commission of Homeopathy Act 2020. Those all talks about the medical pluralism. These three commissions on approving specific pedagogic modules for UG and PG courses across medical system. Simply put, they want to students of allopathic medicines to learn Ayush and vice versa. You see, there can be debate over these backgrounds, but I want to say that academic Ayurveda education in India 2030, what as an academician and stakeholder of Ayurveda academia, what it can be. So one nation, one health system, that is one graduate course integrating all necessary things for health, well-being of mankind. And after the basic graduate course, PG specialization as per the interest of learner. Second option can be continuing with separate graduate courses as existing now, and as per interest of the learner, he or she can take PG education in likely or whatever the system, health system, he or she likes. See, before taking any step, we should have a robust discussion with all government agencies and all stakeholders of Ayurveda especially Ayurveda Academia. Now, the quality education is needed. We are taking steps forward for it, but it must be, those steps must be accelerated. So some necessary, we can say suggestions, or as a Ayurveda Teachers Association National Secretary, I want to suggest here that our Ayush Ministry of Ayurveda should make provision of 25% of budget on education field. Proper discussions and suggestions must be considered from all stakeholders of academic educations like teachers, government authorities, etc. at the time of reforms of MSR, that is minimum standard of regulation of Ayurvedic institutes, that is colleges. Now, outcome teaching learning methods should be adapted for each subject. And very nicely, I am proud to say that the BOG CCIM has already started working over these outcome-based TL methods. Hospital is a soul of health professional course like BMS. Hence, to increase the number of patients for OPDs, IPDs, super specialists from different states of can be appointed to get more exposure and experience to the learners. Definitely, I am talking about the Ayurveda super specialist. To improve the quality of our academic education system, strictly time-to-time monitoring of colleges and hospitals are necessary by the monitoring authorities, by the licensing authorities. Existing Ayurveda colleges and hospitals can be improved, their infrastructure can be improved by funding of Ayush Ministry directly, which will directly benefit to the society as well as the future careers of Ayurveda, that is the students of Ayurveda, graduate students, postgraduate students. So instead of having, you know, various demands or some, you know, projects or proposals, they are, you know, everyone knows Central Council of Indian Medicine, BOG, and Ayush Ministry are also well known about the colleges and their attached hospitals. So direct can, without any condition, they can directly give funding. They can monitor strictly the use or the utility of the funding and can improve the existing colleges, whether they are government, whether they are government-aided colleges and the private colleges also. That will definitely improve the future of Ayurveda in 2030. Uniform pay scale to the teaching faculties as well as non-teaching staff as per the UGC norms and the existing pay commission is needed so that the cream or intellectual graduate, postgraduates, teachers will dedicate and serve the colleges for the teaching and taking care of well-being of the health of the society. So to improve the quality, the staffing pattern of teaching faculty should be revised. Right now we have 14 departments and the either or reader, or we can say professor and associate professor, either or pattern is there. And only Kai Chikitsa department is having three-tier system, that is the professor, associate professor, and assistant professor. But it should not be like that. At least for minimum intake capacity, that is the 60 student intake capacity, one professor, one associate professor, and one assistant professor. And for Sanskrit Samhita department, Samhita Siddhanta department, one extra for the Sanskrit subject. So the teaching experience and qualification in the concerned subject only, and there should be no intermixing of the qualification and experience. Friends, I'm talking about the allied subject teachers. So for that, for suppose Shalya Tantra lecturer 3 years and 7 months, and the Shalakya Tantra lecturer 2 years and 25 days. Now they have been sanctioned for the promotion of the post of the reader in the subject Shalakya Tantra as per the, you know, some situations I am giving examples. So in short, we are lacking the time. I will not explain more about this. So allowing allied subjects to the teacher is not a good idea. So enough professionals are available in a particular subject and they must be allowed. At least for the promotion, that is the associate professor and the professor, It must be from the concerned subject only. Now, this idea has already talked. I will express in another way by seeing the recent activities, positive activities by Ayush Ministry under the leadership of our Prime Minister and Honorable Ayush Minister Sri Shripad Ji Naik. We are expecting the desirous of a bright future for the teachers and the academicians. National institutes of Ayurveda like NIA, BHU, AIIA, etc. There is a need to establish such institute in every state of Ayurveda. Sorry, in every state of our country, this Ayurveda community must be established like on that national institutes. Career advancement schemes are needed for the time-bound promotion and time-bound increments for all the teachers, including the Sanskrit subject. As well, the implementation of skill as per the existing pay scale, and it must have the PF and gratuity facility to secure the future of the academicians who are serving Ayurveda. So we sincerely request to include the representative of Ayurveda Teachers Association in various committees for the proposed NCISM bill. And teachers are an important stakeholders of Ayush. So we think that the NCISM bill should involve the teachers in its new structure, and that will help understand and cater the various demands by the actually field workers that are teachers. We feel that this shall ultimately benefit not only teachers, but it will help to promulgate and flourish Ayurveda as a whole. So I would like to request all of you to work together and to work for a better future of Ayurveda in 2030. So I would like to thank the JAF organizing team and all the, especially Dr. Vishnu, who is continuously taking follow of everything. And we, as a ATA, Ayurveda Teachers Association, we have done maximum to support this event. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable words. Next, I would like to invite Dr. Shivakumar, sir, an eminent personality with